Hello viewers, I welcome you all to the Autonomous Academy. This video covers the analysis of a question paper of MSc second semester. In this video, I am going to do the analysis of a question paper of Atomic and Molecular Physics of year 2018. This question paper contains two sections, section A for 15 marks and section B for 25 marks. So in total, we have 40 marks on the question paper of Atomic and Molecular Physics. Here, we shall begin our discussion with the analysis of short answer type question. The first question that we have is, define a spectroscopy. So, spectroscopy is the branch of physics which deals with the interaction of radiation with matter. As a result of this interaction of radiation with matter, the energy of the electromagnetic radiation either gets emitted or it gets absorbed by the matter in discrete amounts of integral multiple of photons h nu. As a consequence of this interaction, we obtain a spectrum. This spectroscopic technique, any spectroscopic technique, plays an important role in the atomic and molecular physics because the spectroscopic techniques describes completely the structure of atoms and molecules. That means it is a technique which completely describes the atomic and molecular structure. So the next question that we have is, define polarization. So the term polarization stands for the separation between the separation of the positive and negative charges. That means polarization is the phenomenon which gives us separate positive and separate negative charges, or we can say that this phenomenon gives us the separate poles of positive and negative charges in a nuclear, atomic, molecular or in chemical system. So such a phenomenon of the separation of positive and negative charges is known as polarization. Just because of the process of this polarization, we will able to get the dipoles. So, since dipole is the separation of the when the two charges are separated by a small distance. So after the polarization process, we will able to get the dipoles. Next question is, explain dissociation energy. So the energy which is required to break the chemical bond in a molecule, that means you have a molecule, and in that molecule, that molecule is bonded with a chemical bond, and the energy which is required to break completely the chemical bond in a molecule is known as the dissociation energy. Due to this dissociation process, the molecule get completely separates into its atoms. So the dissociation energy actually gives us an idea that how strongly the atoms are bonded to each other. That means if you have more than one atom and they are bonded to each other, so dissociation energy is the parameter which will gives us an idea how strongly the atoms are bonded together. Dissociation energy, since it is an energy, it is measured in the kilojoules per moles unit. Next question is about the explain dissociation product. So in any chemical process or in chemical reaction, we usually deal with the reactants and the product. We have just discussed about the dissociation energy. So dissociation product is defined as a process where the product is obtained in the process of separation of molecules into its atom. That means you have molecule, and after a dissociation process, the molecule gets separated into atoms, or atoms get separated into ions, ions get separated into radicals. So the molecules get separated into its atoms, into its constituent atoms, ions or radicals. So this product obtained in the process of dissociation is known as the dissociation product. Next question that we have is, write limitations of the NMR spectroscopy. So here we have asked the question about the spectroscopic technique, NMR spectroscopy. So NMR, let's try to understand first the NMR spectroscopy. So NMR spectroscopy is a spectroscopic technique which deals with the, or which is used to observe the local magnetic moment around the atomic nuclei. So the magnetic field which is developed around the atomic nuclei is observed with the help of NMR spectroscopic technique, and here NMR stands for nuclear magnetic resonance spectroscopy. So NMR spectroscopy is a versatile technique, but in spite of that, it has some limitations. The first limitation that we have is sensitivity. This NMR spectroscopic technique is relatively low sensitive. That means sensitivity means this particular technique requires a lot of sample into concentration of mm For the analysis, that means if you want to do the analysis of some atom or some molecular structure, then for that particular analysis, we will require here a large amount of concentration of that sample into consideration. So this NMR spectroscopy has a drawback that it is relatively low sensitive. The next limitation is magnetic field drift. Due to this magnetic field drift, these drift can lead to the spectral peaks broadening. The first drawback is that it will lead to the broadening of the spectral peaks, then the distortion of the line shape. So as a result of this drawback, we are not able to interpret the NMR results very easily or very precisely. So these magnetic field drift drawback of the NMR spectroscopy makes the interpretation of NMR results very difficult. So these are the two limitations of a NMR spectroscopy. Next question is, what do you mean by the chemical shift? So here, from the shift, it is very clear that shift means the difference between the two things. So chemical shift is the difference between the two resonant frequency. We know what is the meaning of resonant. So the difference between the resonant frequencies of the two nuclei due to the difference in their local molecular environment. For example, consider you have one nuclei of one atom and another nuclei of another atom. And these two nuclei have different local molecular environment. So due to the different local molecular environment of two nuclei, there will be two different resonant frequency. And the difference between that resonant frequencies of the two nuclei is known as the chemical shift. Symbolically, the chemical shift is represented by the symbol del. These chemical shift arises due to the susceptibility and diamagnetic susceptibility, and these diamagnetic susceptibility effects at the atomic or molecular level are the reason for the arising chemical shift. So this chemical shift del is measured in the units of parts per million, that is ppm. Mathematically, it is defined as del is equal to f sample minus f reference over f reference. So here f sample stands for, it is defining the frequency of the sample into consideration, and f reference is the frequency of the reference compound and divided by the f reference. The chemical shift, here we have the term susceptibility. So here susceptibility is defined by the letter chi, and it is defined as chi is equal to m by h, that is the ratio of the magnetization to the magnetic field intensity is known as the susceptibility. So this diamagnetic susceptibility is the main factor due to which the chemical shift arises. Next is, what do explain hyperfine splitting? So hyperfine splitting, this question is very important in the atomic and molecular physics paper. Hyperfine splitting is actually the phenomenon of a splitting of the spectral line of an atom and molecule. We know very well, with every atom and molecule, the spectral lines are associated, and whenever these atom spectral lines associated with that atom and molecule get splitted, so this phenomenon of splitting is known as the hyperfine splitting. So particularly, the hyperfine splitting arises whenever there is an interaction of electron with the magnetic moments of nuclei. That means when the electrons get interact with the magnetic moments of nuclei, the line, a spectral line associated with the atom or molecule get splitted, and such phenomena is known as the hyperfine splitting, or you can say hyperfine structure. Next question that we have is, explain line width. So as the name clears, width means it is it is measured in millimeters or in micrometers range. So line width is actually the measure of a width of a band of frequencies of radiation emitted or absorbed in an atomic or molecular transition. So for the sake of convenience, let us consider two energy level, and between two energy levels there occurs atomic or molecular transition. As a result of this atomic or molecular transition, we will obtain a band of frequencies, and the width of that band of frequencies is known as the line width. So actually, line width is the measure of the band. This band is composed of the frequencies, and these frequencies of radiation, and these radiation is obtained either by the process of emission or by the process of absorption in an atomic or molecular transition. The last question that we have is, define any one of the following. First is a spin-spin coupling, and second is a Fortrade diagram. So let's try to understand first the spin-spin coupling. So spin-spin coupling, first of all, understand what is this coupling. So in physics, coupling means the interaction of the two objects or the two things. For example, we can consider here the example from classical mechanics, the two connecting system to connected bodies like pendulum. If the two pendulums are connected with each other, interconnected with each other, then this will be said that the two pendulums are coupled with each other. So coupling means simply means that the two objects or two bodies are interacting with each other. So here we have asked about the spin-spin coupling. So here the two objects are simply the spin magnetic moments of two different electron or two different nuclei. So spin-spin coupling is the interaction. Very first of all, it is the interaction because it is a coupling phenomena. So it is the interaction between the spin magnetic moments of two different electron and two different nuclei. That means two different electron and two different nuclei, the spin magnetic moment are interacting. Then this phenomenon is known as a spin-spin coupling. Here magnetic moment is defined as mu is equal to I into A. That is the I represents the current and A represents the area of the cross section in which the electron is revolving. In these spin-spin coupling usually observes in the NMR spectroscopy, and these coupling in NMR spectroscopy give rise to the multiplet patterns and cross peaks in the 2D NMR NMR spectra specifically. The last question is, explain the Fortred diagram. So in spectroscopy, the Fortred diagram is the diagram that allows the nature of the rotational transition, and that nature is the multivariate nature of the rotational transition, which is that is displayed on the computer graphics and the terminals. So the diagram which is allowing the multivariate nature of the rotational transition to be displayed on the computer graphics terminals is known as the Fortred diagram. Let's move to the overview of the long answer type question. So the first question is obtain expression for vibrational Raman spectra. So specifically the question is asked about the Raman spectra, but vibrational Raman spectra. So you have to explain this question along with the help of a diagram. Next is explain techniques used for Raman spectroscopy. So what are the instrument, what are the parts that you have required to define the Raman spectroscopy, to observe the Raman spectrum. So you have to explain the complete technique for the Raman spectroscopy. So next question is obtain electronic spectra for complexes with its application. So for various complexes you have to obtain the electronic spectra along with its application. Next is describe Born-Oppenheimer approximation. This is very important question of in atomic and molecular physics. So here you have to define another approximation technique. Just we have studied in quantum mechanics like WKB approximation and variational method and so on. So just like that method, we have another method in atomic and molecular physics, which is Born-Oppenheimer approximation. So you have to define completely this approximation method. Next is write the quantum description of NMR spectroscopy. So NMR spectroscopy's quantum description, that is that means according to quantum point of view, how the NMR spectroscopy is the quantum characteristics of NMR spectroscopy you have to define. Next is obtain expression for the spin-spin coupling. So we have just discussed the what is the meaning of a spin-spin coupling. It is interaction of the magnetic moment of electrons and the nuclei. But here you have to obtain a mathematical expression for the spin-spin coupling. Next is explain ESR spectroscopy. So here in this question, long answer type question, basically the types of the spectroscopies are asked. First is Raman spectroscopy, then here is NMR spectroscopy, and now this is the ESR spectroscopy. So you have to only explain the ESR spectroscopy. Next is discuss any one application of ESR. So first is question number 9 is totally related with the ESR spectroscopy. And the last one is explain any two. So here we have the this question, a kind of short notes type question. So first is Frank Condon principle. This is again very important question in atomic and molecular physics. Second is line width. We have just defined the line width. Next is the determination of G value. It is G is the Landage's splitting factor. And last one is the Raman effect. So you can choose according to your convenience any of the short notes amongst the four. So this was the overview of the long answer type question. I hope this discussion is clear to you. Still, if you have any query regarding this discussion, then you can post your queries in the comment section. And apart from that, the study material related to this question paper as well as related to your other academics, these study material is available in the Telegram channel of the Autonomous Academy. So take the advantage of that Telegram channel of Autonomous Academy. Thank you so much for watching.